Let us understand in this video the benefit or privileges available to the OPC, one person company, right? The OPC is a blend of the proprietorship plus company. So both the benefits are available to the person who start the company. If any person start a private company or a public company, he is required to comply with a lot of formalities. In the case of OPC, they need not to be bothered about much of the formality. A business which can be currently going on as a proprietorship can be converted into the OPC company without any difficulty. OPC require the minimum capital, right? They can also raise the capital from the venture capital financial institution, right? The mandatory rotation which are applicable for all other companies for auditor, which is a 5 years for individual and 10 years for an audit firm, is not applicable to the OPC. The annual return of the OPC can be signed by the company secretary, or if there is no company secretary, by the director of a company. The provision of section 98 and section 100 to 111, both inclusive, related to the holding of a general meetings, is not applicable to the OPC. The biggest advantage in my opinion. The OPC need not to have a minimum of, need not to have the more directors. One director is a fine, and it can have a more than one directors, up to a maximum 15 directors. But if they would like to appoint the more directors, they will have to pass a special resolution. In the case of any other company, they will have to comply the strictly the provision of board meeting, right? The OPC company required to convey at least one board meeting in each of the half calendar year, right? And the gap between the two meeting should not be less than 90 days. The financial statement of OPC can be signed by the one director alone. And here, the attachment or inclusion of a cash flow statement is not a mandatory. The board report to be annexed to the financial statement may only contain the explanation or a comments by the board on every qualification, reservation, or an adverse remark or a disclaimer made by the auditor in this